Let me introduce myself to you. I am Professor Mohammed Kamar, Professor of Diabetes and Endocrinology, Faculty of Medicine, Zagazig University. My talk in this conference, ECU 2018, was about post-thyroidectomy hypoparathyroidism. Of course, this is a very bad complication. The patient goes to the surgery to remove the thyroid because it causes him some trouble. So he begins to complain from complications like convulsions, numbness, tingling, carpopedal spasm, laryngeal spasm, bronchospasm, which is much disturbing to the patient. So we have to avoid this complication as much as possible. This complication occurs more in patients with large goiter, when the goiter is removed for cancer, when the patient is lactating, when there is past history of bariatric surgery, depleting the calcium of the body, or the patient has malabsorption, like celiac disease, or has Graves' disease, and so on. So we have to predict this complication, and we may measure calcium or maybe vitamin D before operation, and give the patient calcium and vitamin D to replenish the calcium store before doing this operation to avoid post-thyroidectomy hypoparathyroidism. The American Thyroid Association has published in 2016 that following this operation, the patient should measure calcium and parathyroid hormone immediately after operation, because parathyroid hormone is the first thing to happen after removal of the parathyroid before even calcium decreases. Parathyroid hormone is measured within 2 hours or a few hours after the operation. If it becomes decreased, so we start calcium and vitamin D. The decrease in parathyroid hormone after operation may not be permanent because the blood supply to the parathyroid may be compromised during surgery and then recurs again. So 1/3 of thyroidectomies complaining from hypoparathyroidism may revert to normal later on. After operation, if parathyroid hormone is less than 10, we have to give calcium and vitamin D, especially calcitriol, or 125-dehydroxycholecalciferol, and recheck after 2 weeks. If the condition resolves and parathyroid hormone returns to normal, so we stop treatment. If the patient after operation has parathyroid hormone between 10 and 20, so we give calcium only and recheck after operation, after 2 weeks. And if the parathyroid hormone is more than 20, so we do not give any calcium or calcitriol. So we have to predict the occurrence of the complication and to prevent its occurrence. If we give the proper treatment before operation and then we find it not needed, so we can withdraw the treatment. So you have to avoid this complication as much as possible in order to make the patient not to complain. If the patient develops permanent hypoparathyroidism, so the treatment depends on the replacement of calcium, carbonate, 1 gram, 3 times daily, or citrate if the patient is obliged to take PPI or has decreased acidity of the stomach, so we can give him calcium citrate. Another thing is we give him active vitamin D, 125-hydroxycholecalciferol, to increase absorption of calcium. New treatments are now available like parathyroid hormone, teriparatide, and the full-length parathyroid hormone to replace the acquiescent hormone, because when we give this hormone, there is better stability of the serum calcium level and no fluctuation in the clinical condition of the case. And thank you very much.